Hello, this is William Malpede with the Academy of Scoring Arts. This video serves as an introduction to the compositional techniques employed by master composer Jerry Goldsmith in his brilliant score for Planet of the Apes. I will present his 12-tone row, and I have chosen some short examples from the score which demonstrate several uses of the row. There are many more examples to be found throughout the entire score, and I'd like to encourage everyone to have another look at this brilliantly crafted score and film. The first four examples demonstrate the row, sometimes stopping after seven or eight notes, and sometimes using inversions. Two examples demonstrate the use of the two-note dyads formed from the row. The main title also utilizes these. The next four examples feature what I call the main theme, which is really a motif derived from the first three notes of the row. These examples continue to play the entire row, but the declaration of those first three notes, I believe, impresses itself on the listener and becomes a somewhat memorable motif, which is heard throughout the score. The next five examples feature what I call the stress, terror, apes domination motif. It is often featured in action sequences, and I'd like also to make note of the use of the large and small friction drums, which you'll hear, emulating the sound of the apes' grunts and vocalizing. The final two examples demonstrate the use of chords derived from the row. The first is a technique heard earlier in our examples, and that is the two-note dyads, here played on pizzicato strings, run through the tape delay echoplex, and that's also heard throughout the score in different cues. The second example demonstrates chords derived from the row, which are used here to set off the action sequence known as the hunt. And stay tuned, we plan to have a score study of this entire cue coming. Thank you.